count this money, then I count my blessings. If I ever took an L, then it's still for lesson. I'm the one, ain't no second guessing. Tried to dim my light, but my soul fluorescent. Wait, I tried to stay, but depressing. I even prayed to God, he ain't get the message. I'm living in the present, they gon' feel my presence. You can't dim my light, cause I'm luminescent. I rose from the ashes of the section.
A December chill is in the air coming off of Lake Erie, but folks here bundled up, ready for football at Cleveland Browns Stadium in downtown Cleveland. Today it's a Week 14 matchup that should be a good one, as it'll be the Jacksonville Jaguars taking on the Cleveland Browns. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. They go play action with Hurts. He'll buy some time right. This will be caught downfield by Moore. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That one goes for 24 yards.
Time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, be able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
So the completion results there in 9 yards, and that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. The Browns hit 10-2 on the year. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
It's so much about football. It comes down to mindset, being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
Tyquan Thornton, the one he was looking for. And it's second down. You look at this Jaguar defense. This unit, they've struggled a little bit against the pass, ranked number 21 in the league.
And I think you're going to see some changes in the offseason, whether it's through the draft, free agency, maybe even both. They definitely need some help in the secondary.
5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5. Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
A first carry here for Joe Mixon. And this will not be enough. On 3rd and 5, he only gets 3. He handed it off there, but I don't really know if he would have kept it or tried to do anything else if it would have mattered.
Yeah, it's not always a wrong read when a play gets stacked up. Sometimes they're just at the line of scrimmage. There's just too many bodies to maneuver.
And as a result, now they're looking at a 4th down. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown. Decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. on first down, Levis. That's caught by the rookie, Quentin Johnston.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. They'll run. It's Kenneth Walker. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, this defense for the Browns, they were terrific last week in the win over the Rams.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 10 yards there, good enough for the Jags' first down.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
So a 1st and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 44-yard line.
Levis sets up to throw here. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Down the left sideline.
And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Browns' defense has a touchdown. Now Myers for the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
And there, of course, was a lot of talk about this ball game coming into play. Two division leaders in the AFC. Could this be a potential playoff preview down the line?
Yeah, and I think when you talk about the talk about this game coming into play, you're talking about me, because I blew up your phone all week prior to this one. I'm so excited about this game because, to me, it's not out of the realm of possibility that these two teams see each other again down the road. I like this matchup. They match up very well against each other.
And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Consecutive runs of 6 yards gives him a 1st and 10. Again, it's Walker. To about the 35, second down. You look at this Browns defense. They were terrific last week in the win over the Rams.
They held them to just 7 points, and in reviewing the game tape, I'm wondering how they got the 7. I actually wrote a note to myself. How did they even score the way they were playing? Absolutely.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And the Browns are going to take possession here at their own 33.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
At their own 33-yard line.
Play action. Here's Hurts. Got a man. It's Tyquan Thornton.
A big play that time for Cleveland. 41 yards. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10.
Throwing is Hurts.
Steps away to his left. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Partner, the good ones have a clock running in their head, okay? Because it says something like this: I've got this many seconds to find a target. After that, I have to tuck it and try and get some yardage on this first down snap. He doesn't just get some yards, though. He gets a big gain, and they'll come right back with another 1st and 10.
That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and that will bring up second down. That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football, all right? You're not trying to find the laces and grip it a certain way. That takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how they practice it all the time now, too.
On the out route, he's got Thornton. And the Browns are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Running the jet sweep, Thornton. Oh, this one may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. Mixon is in. Touchdown, Cleveland. The extra point now coming from Myers. And it is now 21-0. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
Here we go.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Walker with another carry. And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Levis back to throw. This pass complete to Higgins. It'll go as a gain of 4, and it's second down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Off the play fake, Levis. And he's going to be intercepted for the 3rd time thus far. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Browns are going to get the football back at their own 17.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. It has been about as perfect of a start to this game as these guys could have asked for, Charles. They've scored on their first 2. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Now he's loose down the middle of the field. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Tyquan Thornton, 83 yards. And the Browns continue to pull away here in this first half. Extra point up and through by Myers. And it is 28-0. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away.
But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He'll let it fly for Austin. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Levis now off of play action. Connecting on the out route here with Higgins.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
Here's second and 10. Levis in trouble, down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
The pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. Four sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
Able to find the open man. That's complete.
A big third down play there for the Jags. 41 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down.
Pass to the right, and he's got McBride.
So nothing doing there, and that's going to bring up second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the Browns' 19-yard line.
Working from the gun, here's Levis.
Eluding the pressure right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Well, this defense is certainly organized and playing off of each other because the rush is providing pressure and the coverage is forcing incompletions and capitalizing on mistakes. When you get every level on defense hitting at once, you get first half scores just like this one.
Levis looking to move him around a bit.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
That's complete to McBride.
And he'll only get this to the 14 as he'll come up well short of the first down. It'll be a gain of 5. And it'll be fourth down.
Brandon, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and they stop him well short.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
No move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and 5.
Back to throw. It's Levis.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Jags come up empty on fourth down, and this Browns defense stands tall. The Cleveland offense ready to go.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Second down. Here's Hurts. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off. And they will finally stop it, but a great return gets that football all the way down to the 16-yard line.
First down 10 at the 16-yard line.
Ready up. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now Levis. Escaping the pressure right. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
They made a nice effort to stick it with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
Now second and 9. Levis looking to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Oh, they were so close. That close to their first points of the game. Just needed to hang on just a second longer. But he couldn't complete the process of the catch through the jostling from the defender.
Levis on third down. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Continued struggles here in the second quarter, and to me, you could pin a lot of them on an inability to convert third downs and that most recent incompletion to the list of examples.
Oh, that's offline. He hooked it. It's no good.
Always disappointing when you miss a field goal, but when you're playing against a defense this good, you and I both know that's a crucial miss because you can't afford to leave any points out there. You've got to take them when you can.
The Browns drive about to get started. And just inside of a minute left, Charles, they got a pretty long field ahead of them. I'm curious to see how they play this, but you would think definitely enough time to at least try to get three out of this.
Yeah, you want to move with a nice sense of pace. You want to up the tempo a little bit, but you have to do it with some poise as well. You don't want to go so fast that you hurry yourself into mistakes. There's enough time to put points on the board if they do it right.
And even though they have the lead, you know that they would love to extend.
And this is caught at the 20. And touchdown, Cleveland. David Njoku, as the first half is winding down. And the Browns will extend their lead here just before halftime. Myers connects on the PAT, and a route is on here in this first half.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively off. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Mixon with a first down carry. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Tackle made by Chase Young.
And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here.
The Jaguars with work to do. They trail here as we are back underway on EA Sports. And the fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half. So where do they go from here?
The first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done, and there's no going back. And now you have to play this drive by drive. Obviously, come back in this spot, pretty unlikely. But you still have to go out, take pride in your work, and try and put something together here in the second half.
And a gain of four gets him right to the midfield stripe.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's second and six. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Straight ahead, Walker. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Well, I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Levis. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
It's a gain of 25 yards. And the Jaguars.
First and 10, it's Levis. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
And Johnston sent in motion. Second and 10, here's Levis. He gets it to Johnston, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Here's Levis. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
The passing windows are just not there. And that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
They'll try and run Walker. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Give him 4 yards there, but they're still well short of the goal line with fourth down now looming. Kuhn knocks this one through the post, and they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. So they get the 3 points, but they've now had 3 trips into the red zone, and that's all they've come away with.
And in the NFL, the way they measure red zone efficiency and success, did you score touchdowns on those drives? That's first and foremost. Getting points, that's the second measurement. So by that measure, they haven't done very well. They've got to figure that out.
And the Browns are able to cover this one up. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it,
It was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. And down to the 36-yard line here. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Hitting out a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Back to Mixon on 2nd down. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1.
The way things have gone in this one, the running game's been something of an afterthought, and that's not been too bad for them, has it?
Yeah, the offensive returns have been good, but I guess we figured he and the ground game would be a bit more involved. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. A 3rd down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That's a heck of an effort from Josh Allen getting in there defensively. After the loss, they'll come up 2nd and 13. Once again, they run with Mixon. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Hurts sets up to throw it. That is caught. Unable to corral him. He fights through. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. And that's going to be incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. They'll go again from the 3 here on 2nd and goal. Here's a run with Mixon. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score 1 touchdown,
you want 2.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got 1, but was denied as he tried to get the 2nd one.
And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Jalen Hurts keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Browns will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the 3rd. Extra point up and through by Myers. And the lead grows even larger here in the 3rd quarter. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Well, we're still in the 3rd quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable. Now, a win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to... Left sideline, a dive, and it looks like he's got it. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Yeah. Play action now. Levis.
And now here is another interception.
And the Browns are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. But with this advantage, this defense knew that passes were coming, and they stayed in position, Charles, and picked one off here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, what a way to cap things off, huh? Because I think this is part of the game within the game. They see the scoreboard, they see what they can accomplish, and they went for it.
Oh, nice move. And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of 4.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they gave up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. On third down, Mixon. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. 4 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. That'll move the sticks for the Browns. A gain of 12. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. They try to eat some clock with Mixon. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Here's second and 7. They'll stay on the ground, Mixon again. And they get him behind the line, so that short gain on first down quickly negated. They'll wind up losing 3, and now it's third down.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Mixon up the middle, dances by him. Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. It's a 44-yard punt, just 3 on the return. And it'll be Jaguar football as they take over deep in their own territory. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. Their mini 2-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves them with 2 to go on second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. From the 23, here's second and a couple. Levis sets up to throw here. Finds Johnston. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Levis to throw on first and 10 here. He's got another one to Johnston. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
8 yards on the pickup brings up second and 2 at the 48-yard line.
Trap 60, trap 60.
Second down, here's Levis.
this one is incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops from one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. And Levis going back to the air. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here.
No touch.
No touch. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And it was their defense that led the way, allowing just 3 points, that lone field goal, in the entire second half.
And remember the old adage, offense sells tickets. Defense does what?
Wins championships.
And in this game, maybe a championship wasn't won, but a game was by the defense, right? Held them to just a field goal? That's a heck of a job. I mean, when they went out there with that determination and a pretty good game plan, pretty good idea of what they wanted to accomplish, just love the execution, love the tenacity, love the way they finished.
So for the Browns, the win pushes their record now to 11-2 on the year. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Chicago Bears next week. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, it's a loss that could have implications on the playoff race as they fall to 9-4. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home.
Street without a wedding band. I done peeped at all the these rappers when they secondhand my